Hello everyone, good day for all. Welcome back to yet another episode of Ayush Samveda, a smart way to Ayurveda. I'm Dr. Kavya Vasudev and you're watching Study Ashtanga Hridaya series. Please subscribe to my channel and enable the bell button for continuous updates in Samhita. In the last videos, we were discussing about Matrashtiya Adhyaya and we discussed the Amajanya Vikaras and Ajirna from this chapter. If you have not watched those videos, please click the I button to access them. Moving with the same chapter, next different types of food habits has been mentioned which is not good for the health. Mishram Pathyam Apathyam Cha Bhuktam Samashanam Madam Vidyad Adhyashanam Bhuyo Bhuktasya Upari Bhojanam Akale Bahu Cha Alpam Va Bhuktam Tu Vishamashanam Trini Api Etani Mrityum Va Ghoran Vyadhin Srijanti Va Mishram Pathyam Apathyam Cha Bhuktam Samashanam Madam Vidyad Adhyashanam Bhuyo Bhuktasya Upari Bhojanam अकाले बहु च अल्पं वा भुक्तं तु विषमाशनं त्रीणि अपि एतानि मृत्युं वा घोरान् व्याधीन् सृजन्ति वा मिश्रं पथ्यं अपथ्यं च भुक्तं समशनं मतं विद्यात् अध्यशनं भूयो भुक्तस्य उपरि भोजनं अकाले बहु च अल्पं वा भुक्तं तु विषमाशनं त्रीणि अपि एतानि मृत्युं वा घोरान् व्याधीन् सृजन्ति वा. The different types of food habits such as samashana, that is mishram pathyam apathyam, consuming the suitable and unsuitable foods mixed together, that is pathya means which is good for our health or which is especially when a person is taking the medicines or the treatments, we will be advising him to take the pathyas and to avoid the apathyas, that is which is best for that particular condition or good for the health. So pathya and apathya aharas when mixed together and consumed, then such condition or such habits is called as samashana. Next is adhyashana, bhuktasya upari bhojanam, that is consuming large quantity of food even before the previous food got digested, that is bhuktasya upari bhojanam. Once we have taken the food and before getting digested, we will be taking another quantity or another meal. Such habit of taking food is called as adhyashana. Next is vishamashana, अकाले बहु च अल्पं वा भुक्तं, दैट इज अकाल भुक्त और भोजना इज कॉल्ड एज विषमाशन, दैट इज अनटाइमली कंसम्पशन ऑफ फूड इज कंसिडर्ड एज विषमाशन. And even if it is being taken in little quantity or in large quantity, it is considered as vishamashana or it is not good for the health. That is all these the three things, that is samashana, adhyashana and vishamashana are not good for our health. And all these three can cause different varieties of diseases, that is ghoran vyadhin, severe diseases can be manifested or even death can also be produced because of these kinds of food habits. That is samashana means mixing pathya and apathya aharas, adhyashana means before getting the previous meal digested again consuming the food, and vishamashana means akala bhojana, that is untimely food intake, either it can be less quantity or large quantity. Next is ahara vidhi, how we have to consume food or what are the rules and regulations which we have to consider while taking the food is being mentioned. Kale satmyam shuji hitam snigdhoshnam lakhu tanmanaha shadrasam madhura prayam nadi druta vilampitam snadaha kshudvan viviktasto dhauda pada karananaha tarpayitva pitrun devan adhidin balakan gurun pratyaveksha तिरश्चौ अपि प्रतिपन्न परिग्रहान समीक्ष सम्यक आत्मानं अनिंदन अभ्रुवन द्रवं इष्टमिष्टैहि सहाश्नीयात् शुचि भक्त जनाहृतं भोजनं तृण केशादि जुष्टं उष्णीकृतं पुनः शागा अवरान्न भूयिष्टं अत्युष्ण लवणं त्यजेत्. काले सात्म्यं शुचि हितं स्निग्ध उष्णं लघु तन्मनाः षड् रसं मधुर प्रायं न अतिद्रुत विलंपितं स्नातः क्षुद्वान् विविक्तस्तो धौत पाद कर आननः तर्पयित्वा पितृन् देवान् अतिथीन् बालकान् गुरून् प्रत्यवेक्ष तिरश्च अपि प्रतिपन्न परिग्रहान् समीक्ष सम्यक् आत्मानम् अनिन्दन् अभ्रुवन् द्रवम् इष्टम् इष्टैः सह आश्नीयात् शुचि भक्तजनाहृदम् भोजनम् तृणकेशादि जुष्टम् उष्णीकृतम् पुनः शाखा अवरान्न भूयिष्टम् अति उष्ण लवणम् त्यजेत् काले सात्म्यम् शुचि हितम् स्निग्ध उष्णम् लघु तन्मनाः षड्रस मधुरप्राय न अतिद्रुत विलम्पितम् स्नातः क्षुद्वान् विविक्तस्तो धौत पादकर आननः तर्पयित्वा पितृन् देवान् अतिथीन् बालकान् गुरून् प्रत्यवेक्ष तिरश्च अपि प्रतिपन्न परिग्रहान् समीक्ष सम्यक् आत्मानम् अनिन्दन् अभ्रुवन् द्रवम् इष्टम् इष्टैः सह आश्नीयात् शुचि भक्तजनाहृदम् भोजनम् तृणकेशादि जुष्टम् उष्णीकृतम् पुनः शाखा अवरान भूयिष्टम् अति उष्णलवणम् त्यजेत् सो वाट् आर् द रूल्स् अण्ड् रेगुलेशन्स् टु बी केप्ट् इन् मैण्ड् फुड् वैल् टेकिङ्ग् द फुड् काले दट् इस् द फुड् हेस् टु बि कन्स्यूम्ड् एट् द प्रापर् time. Improper timings of the food consumption is not good for the health. If we are proper time, if we are consuming the food at the proper time, then the proper digestion also will be taking place. So at the proper time, we have to consume the food. And satmya. Satmya aharas should be consumed. That is, satmya means which is being accustomed. But like there are certain dravyas like kshira, dhadi or such dravyas which are good for our condition or it is being accustomed from the birth time or from the long time we will be using that thing and it will be habit for us. Such aharas which we are regularly using, such aharas should be used. The aharas which are satmya for our condition should be taken. Then shuchi, clean aharas should be taken. Hita, that is suited for the health, which is good for our health condition or good for our prakriti or good for our koshta or based on the akni, such good food we have to consume. Then snigdha ushnam lakhu, the food which is snigdha ushna and lakhu aharas should be consumed. Tanmanaha, that is while taking food we have to be in concentration for taking the food itself. We should not concentrate on another things. We have to concentrate our mind on the in consumption of the food. With due attention towards the food we have to consume the food. So that is kala in the proper time, satmya aharas, the food which is shuchi and hita, which is having snigdha, ushna and lakhu gunas, and also tanmana. By due attention to the food consumption has to be given while taking food. And the food should be shadrasam madhuraprayam. That is, all the six rasas should be present in the food. Or we have to consume the foods which are having all the six rasas. We have to take all the six rasas. But especially madhuraprayam. Madhura rasa aharas should be consumed a little more. And nadi drudha vilampitam. And while taking the food, we should not be take very slowly or very quickly. That is nadi drutam, that is very quickly, or nadi vilampitam, very slowly. In both ways we should not consume the food. We have to consume it in a proper way. That is, if we are taking it in druta, that is very quickly, we won't enjoy the taste or we won't enjoy the rasas of the food. And if we are taking very slowly, then the food will be getting contaminated or it will become very cold and all. So it also won't be good for our health condition. So we should not take the food very slowly and also very quickly. Next is snadaha. After taking bath, we have to consume the food. And kshudvan, and also when we are hunger, when we are having the good appetite or good hunger, at that time we have to consume the food. Then viviktasta. Viviktasta means we have to be sit properly at a particular area, and after that we have to consume the food. That is, in the place should be good and we have to be well arranged for the food consumption. Dhauta pada karananaha, after washing the pada, kara and anana, that is feet, hands and face. After cleaning this or after washing these feet, hands and face, after that we have to take the food. तर्पयित्वा पितृन् देवान् अतिथीन् बालकान् गुरुन्। सो बिफोर वी कंस्यूम द फूड वी हैव टू गिव तर्पयित्वा, दैट इज आफ्टर सैटिस्फाइंग द पितृ, दैट इज लाइक द फोर फादर्स हू हैव ऑलरेडी डेड, एंड देवा द गॉड अतिथि, द इफ गेस्ट आर देयर वी हैव टू फर्स्ट सर्व देम, देन बालकान, दैट इज द चिल्ड्रन इन द होम हैज टू बी गिवन द फर्स्ट एंड गुरु, दैट इज इफ द elderly people has to be fed first. So Pitru, Deva, Atithi, Bala and Guru, such people has to be fed first, or they have to be served food first, after that only we have to consume the food. And also Pratipanna Parigrahan Tirascha Abhi Pratyaveksha, and the other people who are dependent on us, like the birds or animals which are being in our home, or the pet animals or birds, or the other persons or the people who are dependent on us, they should also be served the food. After that only we should take the food. आत्मानं सम्यक् समीक्षा, आफ्टर केयरफुली कंसिडरिंग वन्स ऑन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन और वन्स ऑन प्रकृति और वन्स ऑन लाइक्स एंड डिसलाइक्स, वन हैज टू डिसाइड व्हाट काइंड ऑफ फूड ही हैज टू टेक, एंड आफ्टर दैट ओनली ही शुड कंस्यूम द फूड. सो आत्मानं, दैट इज वन सेल्फ, ही हैज टू एग्जामिन फर्स्ट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ फूड ही नीड्स, और व्हाट इज द बॉडी कंडीशन एट दैट पर्टिकुलर टाइम. एवरी डे द कोष्ठा और अग्नि वोंट बी प्रॉपर, और इट वोंट बी same at the all time. So based on that things we have to examine first, or we have to determine what kind of food we have to take, or what likes and dislikes we have, and what is our prakriti, and what actually we need, what quantity of food we need, such all things we have to take care of, or we have to examine. After that we have to consume the food. And anindan, we should not abuse or we should not scold the food. We have to give due respect to the food and we have to consume that. And abruvan, like while taking the food we should not talk too much, we should concentrate on the food itself, we should not concentrate on other things while taking the food. And abruvan, that is we should not talk too much while taking the consumption of the food. And dravam, that is more of liquid food items we have to consume, that is ruksha aharas we should avoid, and a little bit of liquid food items or drava aharas has to be taken in more quantity. And ishtam, the food which is being liked by us has to be taken. If a food we are taking is not liked by us, or it is not good, or it is not liked, then it won't be properly digested. We have seen the ajirna or the ama utpatti. Other than adimatra, there are certain other factors which also mentioned for the ama utpatti. So in that mental emotions also comes, or mental factors are also responsible for the ama utpatti. So if we are not liking a particular food item and if we are consuming that, then there are chances for the ama utpatti, or it won't be get properly digested also. So the food which is being liked by us has to be taken. And ishtehi saha ashneyat, and we have to take the food, or we have to consume the food in company of the people whom we like, or we like to share the company. In such company we have to consume the food. Then shuji bhakta janahritam, and this food has to be cooked and served by the people who are shuji, who is very clean, and bhakta janahritam, that is who is very faithful to the person. Such food has to be consumed. And also the foods which we should not take also mentioned. Food which is being contaminated by trina, kesha, etc., that is grass, hair, or such other unedible items are there. The food which is being getting contaminated, such foods should not be consumed. Then punaha ushnikritam, that is reheated food items should not be consumed. Already the food has been prepared and again we are reheating that food and consuming. It is not good for the health. So such reheated food items should be avoided. And shaka avaranna, that is more of vegetables or shaka, and avaranna, that is in 5th and 6th chapters we have seen very different types of food items, and also the best and inferior types among these all vargas has been mentioned. So among this anna, or whatever aharas which we are consuming, the avara variety or the inferior variety of all the ahara vargas should be avoided. avoided. The superior variety has to be consumed. So Shaka and Avarana has to be avoided. And Atyushna Lavanam. Ati Ushna and Ati Lavana Aharas should also be avoided. That is, in very salty and very hot Aharas should be avoided. That should not be consumed. So these are the Ahara Vidhi which are being mentioned. How to take food? Which all kinds of food we have to take? In what are the things which we have to perform before taking food, or what are the things which we have to keep in mind while taking the food, and what all things we have to do, the rules and regulations for taking the food has been mentioned in Ahara Vithi. Next is Apathya Dravya. That is, there are certain dravyas which we should not consume regularly. On a daily basis or regularly, we should not consume certain dravyas. Such dravyas are considered as Apathya Dravya. They are Kilada, Dadi, Kurchika, Kshara, Shukta, Ama Moolakam, Krisha, Shushka, Varaha, Avi, Go, Matsya, Mahisha, Amisham, Masha, Nishpava, Shaluka, Bisabishta, Virudhakam, Shushka Shakani, Yavakan, Fanidamcha, Na Shilayit, Kilata, Dadi, Kurchika, Kshara, Shukta, Ama Moolakam, Krisha, Shushka, Varaha, Avi, Go, Matsya, Mahisha, Amisham, Masha, Nishpava, Shaluka, Bisa, Pishta, Virudhakam, Shushka Shakani, Yavakan, Fanitamcha, Na Shilayit, Kilata, Dadi, Kurchika, Kshara, Shukta, Ama Moolakam, Krisha, Shushka, Varaha, Avi, Go, Matsya, Mahisha, Amisham, Masha, Nishpava, Shaluka, Bisapishta, Virudhakam, Shushka Shakani, Yavakan, Fanitamcha, Na Shilayet. So Kilada, it is a milk product in which the boiled milk is being added to the curd, and that particular curd preparation is being produced, and this is considered as Apathya because it is Doshala, that is, it increases all the three doshas. So this Kilada has not to be consumed. Then Dadhi, curd, it produces Jwaradi, Vyadi, and it is also Srotolepa, that is, it produces Srotolepa, that is, obstruction to the srotas will be produced, and this obstruction to the srotas will in turn produces all the diseases, Jwaradi, Vyadi, different varieties of Vyadis will be produced. And also in the 6th chapter it has been mentioned, that is, in the 5th chapter it has been mentioned that Dadhi should not be consumed daily, and if it is being consumed daily, then it will produce certain conditions such as Jwara, Shofa, etc. So this Dadhi is not good for consumption on a regular basis. Next is Kurchika, again a milk product in which unboiled milk is mixed with the curd, and it also should not be consumed on regular basis because it is also Doshala, that is, increases all the doshas. Next is Kshara, that is, alkali preparations. It is Pumsatva Hanikrit, that is, it reduces or it hampers the virility. Because of that, Kshara is not consumed. Kshara should not be consumed on regular basis. Next, Shukta, that is, vinegar. It is Drishti Hani. It is not good for the eyes or vision, so it should not be consumed regularly. Ama Moolaka, that is, uncooked radish should not be consumed. Krisha, Shushka, Amisha. Amisha means the meat. The meat of Krisha, that is, emaciated, and Shushka, dried meat. So, the meat of emaciated animals and also the dried meat should not be consumed. Then, meat of Varaha, Avi, Go, Matsya, Mahisha should not be consumed. And Masha, that is, black gram, Nishpava, the varieties of bean, Shaluka, that is, tuberous roots, Bisa, lotus stalk, Pishta means the anna or the cereals which are being grinded and it is made a paste, and then other food items are being prepared. Such Pishta Aharas should not be consumed regularly. Virudhaka, that is, sprouts like green gram or other pulses will be sprouted, pulses will be using. Such sprouts should not be used daily. Shushka Shaka, that is, dried leafy vegetables. Yavaka, a variety of shali. And Fanita, that is, molasses. Such things should not be consumed on the regular basis. And next is Pathya Aharas. That is, we can consume daily basis. They are the dravyas. शीलयेद् शालि गोधूम यव शाष्टिक जांगलम सुनिशन्नक जीवंती बालमूल वास्तुकम पथ्या आमलक मृद्विका पटोली मुद्गशर्करा घृत दिव्योदक क्षीर क्षौद्र दाडिम सैंधवम शीलयेद् शालि गोधूम यव शाष्टिक जांगलम सुनिशन्नक जीवंती बालमूल वास्तुकम पथ्या आमलक मृद्विका पटोली मुद्ग शर्करा घृत दिव्योदक क्षीर क्षौद्र दाडिम सैंधवम शीलयेद् शालि गोधूम यव षष्टिक जांगलम सुनिशन्नक जीवंती बालमूल वास्तुकम पथ्या आमलक मृद्विका पटोली मुद्ग शर्करा घृत दिव्योदक क्षीर क्षौद्र दाटिम सैंधवम सो द फूड आइटम्स विच वी कैन डेली कंस्यूम और रेगुलरली कंस्यूम आर शाली दैट इज अ वैरायटी ऑफ द पैडी और राइस गोधूम वीट यवा बार्ली षष्टिका अगेन अनदर वैरायटी ऑफ व्रीही धान्य जांगल मांस सुनिशन्नगा जीवंदी सजाद औषध वर्ग और इवन कंसिडर्ड एज वेजिटेबल बालमूल दैट इज इमेच्युअर रैडिश वास्तुका एंड पटोला अगेन टू वेजिटेबल्स पथ्य और हरीतकी एंड आमलका मृद्विका दैट इज ग्रेप्स मुद्गा ग्रीन ग्राम शर्करा शुगर घृदा घी दिव्योदक रेन वाटर और द वाटर विच इज बीइंग कंस्यूम्ड एंड क्षीर मिल्क क्षौद्र हनी दाडिम दट इज पॉमग्रेनेट एंड सैंधव साल्ट दीज आर द फूड आइटम्स विच वी कैन कंस्यूम ऑन द रेगुलर बेसिस एंड दीज आर कंसिडर्ड पथ्य और सात्म्य नेक्स्ट इज त्रिफला मधुसर्पिभ्याम निशि नेत्रबलाय च स्वास्थ्य अनुवर्तिकृत च रोगोच्छेदकरं चयत् त्रिफलां मधु सर्पिभ्यां निशि नेत्रबलाय च स्वास्थ्य अनुवृत्तिकृत् यत् च रोगोच्छेदकरं चयत् त्रिफलां मधु सर्पिभ्यां निशि नेत्रबलाय च स्वास्थ्य अनुवृत्तिकृत् यत् च रोगोच्छेदकरं चयत् सो द डेली बेसिस वी हैव टू कंस्यूम त्रिफला दैट इज आमलकी हरीतकी एंड विभीदकी दिस त्रिफला हैज टू बी मिक्स्ड विद मधु एंड सर्पी दैट इज हनी एंड घी एंड दिस हैज टू बी कंस्यूम डेली नाइट एंड इट विल बी हेल्पिंग इन नेत्र बला दैट इज इट हेल्प्स इन इंप्रूविंग द विजन और स्ट्रेंथनिंग द eyesight so for that purpose we have to consume this tribhala mixed with madhu and sarpi daily at the night time and also the food which we have to consume daily or regularly should be swasthya anuvrittikrit that is the food which improves the health should be consumed on the daily basis and rogochhedakara that is the food which cure the diseases should also be consumed so the food which helps in improving the health or swasthya and the food which help in reducing or curing the diseases such foods should be consumed on the regular basis or on the daily basis the order of meals how to take the food items बिसेक्षु मोज चोज आम्र मोदक उत्कारिकादिकं आद्याद्रव्यं गुरु स्निग्धं स्वादु मंदं स्थिरं पुरः विपरीत मदश्चांदे मध्ये अम्ललवणोत्कटं बिस इक्षु मोज चोज आम्र मोदक उत्कारिकादिकं अद्याद् द्रव्यं गुरु स्निग्धं स्वादु मंदं स्थिरं पुरः विपरीतं अतः च अन्ते मध्ये अम्ल लवणोत्कटं बिस इक्षु मोज चोज आम्र मोदक उत्कारिकादिकं अद्याद् द्रव्यं गुरु स्निग्धं स्वादु मंदं स्थिरं पुरः विपरीतं अतः च अन्ते मध्ये अम्ल लवणोत्कटम् First, adhyad, that is the first or initially we have to consume the food which such as bisa, that is lotus stalk, ikshu, sugar cane, moja, banana, chocha, jackfruit, amra, mango, modaga, the sweet which is having stuffed sweet, utkarika, a type of rice recipe. The foods which are guru, snigdha, swadu, manda and sthira. Such foods has to be consumed initially. That is, in the beginning of the consumption of food, we have to consume the foods which are guru, snigdha, swadu, manda, and sthira. And few examples they have provided, such as bisa, ikshu, mocha, chocha, etc. So such kinds of foods are guru, snigdha, etc. So such aharas should be consumed in the beginning. And viparitam, ante. The foods which are having opposite qualities such as laku ahara etc. has to be consumed at the end of the meal, and madhye, that is at the middle of the meal, we have to take amla and lavana aharas. So in the beginning we have to consume the food which is guru, snigdha, madhura rasa etc., and in the opposite qualities we have to consume at the end time, that is which is ruksha or laku and katu etc. we have to consume at the end time, and in the middle time or middle of the meal we have to take amla and lavana ahara. Annena kukshe द्वावंशो पानेन एकं प्रपूरयेत् आश्रयं पवनादीनां चतुर्थम् अवशेषयेत्. अन्नेन कुक्षेः द्वौ अंशौ पानेन एकं प्रपूरयेत् आश्रयं पवनादीनां चतुर्थम् अवशेषयेत्. अन्नेन कुक्षेः द्वौ अंशौ पानेन एकं प्रपूरयेत् आश्रयं पवनादीनां चतुर्थम् अवशेषयेत्. सो वी हैव टू कंसिडर दिस स्टमक एज थ्री पार्ट्स, एंड हाफ पोर्शन ऑफ द स्टमक वी हैव टू take the solid food items. Anna has to be filled in the kukshi for the half portion, dvau amsho, that is half portion of the stomach has to be filled with the ahara or the solid food items, and the next 1/4 portion has to be consumed with the pana, that is if we are considering this stomach into four parts, two parts of the stomach has to be consumed with ahara, that is annena kuksho dvau amsho, dvau amsha, two parts of the stomach has to be filled with the anna, then panena ekam prapuret, and the one portion has to be filled with the pana or the liquid items, and so already three portions are done. The next fourth part we have to be kept it as empty for the proper functioning of the doshas. So ashrayam pavanadinam, that is the doshas has to do the pajana or the digestion has to be done by the doshas, that is in especially the pachaka pitta, the different kinds of Aknis, and also the different types of Vata, Pitta and Kapha doshas will be helping in the digestion process. So for that proper functioning of these doshas, we have to keep it one portion of the stomach empty. So we have to divide the stomach into four portions, and two portions of the stomach has to be filled with the ahara or anna, that is solid food. One portion has to be filled with watery foods or the liquid food items, and the next one portion has to be left it as empty or free for the proper functioning of the doshas for the proper digestion process. Today we discussed a portion of Matrashriya Adhyaya from Ashtanga Hridaya Sutrasthana. We will be continuing the same chapter in the next videos. For more updates on Samhita, make sure you subscribe the channel. Thank you. See you in the next video. Till then, bye.